Someone who understands NOAA from the inside, Monica Medina, who's a former principal deputy undersecretary at NOAA, former general counsel for the agency, also the co-founder of environmental news site Our Daily Planet. Let's start with that. I mean, that is such an amazing snapshot of the ethos of the folks that work as civil servants in this agency to produce factual information for the public.
And they do it every day, day in, day out. They are true blue public servants. They fly through hurricanes. They worked round the clock during this storm to deliver the most accurate information that every single other weather forecast works from. And to have them be undermined that way was just really abhorrent.
What do you, so there's two things that happen here, right? I mean, there's Wilbur Ross, according to the reporting, threatening to fire folks at NOAA because of the contradiction. And then a statement, an unnamed statement put out by the NOAA communications office, essentially disassociating themselves with the tweet of the Birmingham National Weather Service office and basically saying the president was not wrong.
Right.
Why does that matter?
It matters because those forecasters need to know that the political leadership at NOAA will back them up, and now they don't. They'll think twice. It could take them extra time to get that correction out, and it could be just misinformation that came from anywhere. But now they'll worry that they shouldn't make those corrections, and that time that they lose in getting the clearance to put those correct information out is critical. And I honestly think what Ross did was beyond it, you know, to save the president and his thin skin and his fragile ego. It's not more important than saving the lives of Americans. It's just not.
Do you think he should resign?
I do think he should resign.
You think it's that serious?
I think it's that serious.
I mean, he denies it, I should also say.
Right. It's a basic public trust agency. It runs on the trust within the agency that the leadership will allow them to do their job, and it runs outside the agency on the trust that the public has that the forecast is right. And now Trump's supporters may think it's wrong.
Right. Right. That, like, it's some liberal, it's a bunch of libs there. You can't trust them when they tell you that the tornado is coming for you.
Yes. And every day at Our Daily Planet, we try to explain why these stories matter. And this is not the only time when the public's trust has been violated because they've undermined scientific integrity within an agency. But this time, the public's safety in the immediate time frame was put at risk by this.
We should say that NOAA's chief scientist is going to investigate why the agency backed Trump over its experts on Dorian.
As he should.
There's also a broader question here, which you just referred to, which is this is an agency that, aside from the National Weather Service, does a ton of climate work.
A ton.
And there has been, from the moment the Trump administration took over, worries about precisely this. Would they be able to maintain their scientific integrity and independence amidst pressure from this administration? And we've already seen them start to do things at EPA, at USDA, where they moved a bunch of climate scientists out of Washington to kind of get rid of them. Like, does this concern you about what it means for
Absolutely.
The future of NOAA?
Absolutely. And these storms are getting more and more severe. We've seen five Category 5s in the last 3 years. This is critical that we have this climate information that we need, that we actually need to grow the Weather Service to be able to handle this kind of a stress. The storms are coming at us, the floods, the fires. We don't even have the ability to do the kind of fire forecasting that we have for tornadoes and floods and hurricanes. We need to expand the Weather Service, strengthen them, empower them, give them more resources to take on this incredible challenge that we have ahead of us.
What does it mean for the sort of for everyone else throughout the federal government, not just in NOAA, who are functioning as civil servants, who are working on all sorts of things that have to do with climate or other independent scientific findings, to watch this all play out in public?
I think it's an earthquake. I've heard from people at NOAA myself who say they're devastated and they're worried that the agency won't be able to recover. And surely all their colleagues, they work with other agencies every single day. People talk. They understand the threat here. It's wonderful that Louis Uccellini is willing to speak up and that Craig McLean, the head of science at NOAA, is willing to investigate. And I hope that empowers the civil servants to keep trying to do their job every day. But I worry that the chilling effect has already set in.
Does it have an effect? I mean, people don't want to lose their jobs.
People don't want to lose their jobs, and they don't want to have to worry and make those second
right.
guesses.
It's the second beat in your head.
Yes, and in fact, sometimes that time is critical. In Alabama, in 2015, there was a storm that came through. There was a regatta going on, and the locals didn't really heed the forecast. Six people died. six people died in the course of a day as the forecast changed. Six people died because they were in harm's way because they were having fun sailing in the Mobile Bay. And instead, now we've got the president undermining that local forecast office.
That's a great point. Monica Medina, thank you so much for being
here. Thank you, Chris, for having me.
I should say that Monica's group, Our Daily Planet, is one of the co-sponsors for our 2020 Climate Forum. That's next Thursday and Friday. My colleague, Ali Velshi, and I will be asking presidential candidates about their climate change plans. They will be fielding questions from young voters on climate issues.